More locations, more choices, more convenience. The new Peters Auto Sports, located in Tyler, is ready to serve East Texas. The largest inventory of trucks, cars, motorcycles, ATVs, side-by-sides in all of East Texas. Shop our inventory on our website at petersautosports.com to see all our inventory and take advantage of our nationwide free delivery. Peters Auto Sports in Tyler. More locations, more choices, more convenience.
Tis the season for savings at Adams Furniture and Appliance. Hi, I'm Brian Adams, and let us help you get your home ready for Christmas with savings up to 20% store-wide. Save $400 on the Nashville reclining sofa and loveseat. Both pieces now only $15.99. The Bardstown dining table with four chairs is only $7.19. And get the Emily Queen Bedroom Group for only $12.39. Get up to 5 years no interest on your purchase, or get 90 days same as cash with no credit needed. Shop anytime at AdamsFurnitureOnline.com. Tis the season for savings at all Adams Furniture locations.
Is on the way. Lions will take it inside the 5 yard line and they're going to bring it out. Going left, this is 8, it appears up to the 20, and he's still on his feet out past the 25 yard line. Double check the number 8 like 30 or 8. So the Lions will start first and 10 about the 26 yard line. That was a 3-play, 17 yard drive. The Lions will be brought to you by Josh Field with Edge Ball and Bond. Here's our touchdown run by Jackson. It is 42-0 game. This will be the Lions' first possession of the second quarter.
Maybe the Lions can just tell you what it is in fourth on the board.
They have Kenyonte Cooper still in the quarterback. Sanchez, as Reggie said earlier, banged up this year and hasn't played since the first period. And there's a collision between the running back and quarterback. And once again, Carr's all over that. That's a loss of about 4 yards on that play. Carr has been in the backfield almost as much as some of the running backs tonight.
Second.
And that is a loss of 5 yards back to the 22-yard line. It'll be second down. Do you do it on the ground or through the air? They were minus yardage on the ground in the first half, rolling out. Finish that thought in a moment as they chase Pickard back to the 12. He throws it away. And once again, he had a Lobo barely laying down on him defensively that time. That is going to be Charlie Templeton, the senior linebacker, and it'll be a third down. Do you run or do you throw?
Well, the best chance is going to be. But the receivers and the speakers that have, the best chance is to maybe Wade and Cox.
This has been a tough night for the offensive line here, Lions too. Third down and 15, 9:28. Left in the third, just underway. Looking to throw Pickard in big trouble. Now scrambling again. Looking, he's going to touch it 30. Out to the 33-yard line, scoring the first down. A nice open field tackle made on the edge over there by the Lobo defender.
Marquelin,
and it'll be fourth down. And there may have been a flag on that play. Looks like our referee, Lance Mathis, is going to tell us something here momentarily. Did I see a flag?
I thought it was. I thought it was false start.
Well, he is there. Now he's coming over. Looks like he's going to make whatever call he's going to make here.
Offsides, defense, number 26. That's a 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
All right. So that'll be a third. That will make it a third down of about 10 instead of third and 15. So the Lions will continue on the pickup here on the freebie. And now on the third and 10 at their own 27-yard line. They go left to right here in the third. They wear their blue pants, their blue helmets with the silver leaping on them. Black jersey group, blue normal, pink and white. All of you in there, white shorts and totally white pants and jerseys with the green helmets and the rocket L. Pickard in the backfield and the other guy is recapping tonight. Secondary and linebacker group is Damian Isaac. He's made some plays. That's his second sack. And now it's 4th and 17.
It's not a loss in that game.
Yeah, the offensive line has been a tough, tough night for that group. They have really struggled against this Lobo team.
It's been pretty tough all season, Bill.
Fourth and 17. And the snap, Moon goes to kick it away. Barely gets that one off. It's a low punt. He fielded at the 47-yard line. But by Dylan Davis. He had Dylan track the ball around him that time. Hung in there, grabbed it, picked up about 5 yards from the punt. Lobos in the end zone. Tyler had 43 yards. 8:14 to go here in the third quarter. And again, a bevy, again, of subs in the game right now for the Lobos, including apparently a new quarterback in the ballgame. We may get a dose tonight of Isaiah Harris, the junior quarterback, for the first time tonight. Harris, a stocky kid, and this is the first time we've seen him out of the I formation from the 43-yard line. Harris will hand the football to Harris. Jackson again, big hole through. 25, it's a foot race to the 15, inside the 10, down to the 6-yard line. And it'll be first and goal Lobos, and another touchdown saving tackle made by who else? Trayvon Hayes, first and goal Lobos.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it's been running even over the club in the Premier League. It's just trying to make a shot, but unfortunately, they didn't get guarded out of those
points. But David Jackson looked pretty good. He had the touchdown before the half. And it'll be a first and goal at the 7-yard line of the right half. Right formation again. Harris, Isaiah Harris, the quarterback, under center. Hand the football off to the fullback, and he's still spinning, and he's going to get it to the 1-yard line and close to the goal line. And I think he's going to come up a little bit short, and there's a penalty flag, and maybe a personal foul so bad after a run that time to the goal line. But number 31, Robert Vincent, what's the flag about?
I just see one of Tyler high players go to plunk, and he's coming out of the game with Coach Lane's about to let him know about it. Wasn't very smart at all, Bill.
Yeah, that's a bad, bad situation as he comes over. And I've heard Rickland, when he started, he was in like Allen, he's a very good player. He's had a good career. He gets a pat on the back now. But they stay in the inside.
Personal foul. 32 of the defense. He blew a punt. He's been disqualified.
Sophomore gets thrown out of the game.
No matter how bad the game gets, you got to still have this sports.
All right, so that's half the distance to go, which means about, what, 6 inches. So it's at the lip of the cup here as the Lobos line up inside the 1-yard line. Up 42 to zip, on the verge of punching another one in here. Four of their 6 touchdowns have been on the ground tonight. And they've got their 2 big running backs, so both backups in the game, Vincent and Jackson, with Harris the quarterback. Under center, Harris bobbles the snap and falls on it, has to eat it. It's a 3-yard line. He wanted to hand the ball off to fullback Vincent, who's going to get a chance to score, but not that time. The young quarterback, Harris, bobbled the snap, and he has to go to the ground. And the Lobos going to send, I think, a new quarterback in the game. And there is a Longview player down. One of their offensive linemen is on the ground. We wish him the best. It's Blair Williams, one of their guards, who is on the field. And there is an injury pause here with 6:52 to go in the third quarter as the trainers attend to Blair Williams of the Longview Lobos. Big kid. And I've seen the Lobos for, been doing these football games for well over 20 years. I've seen the great ones like Trent Williams come through and play for the Lobos, and so many of their fine football players, but they have always produced good offensive linemen. They've had some undersized kids play up there, but they've run the same basic system for so long.
Right.
Everybody, by the time they become Lobos, they kind of know the players,
right.
And so, therefore, they are able to execute.
That's good. That's what you mean. That's what you call building a foundation, building a program. Because you start from middle school on up, and by the time those middle school guys are, all of us are going to have
that. This was an issue for Titus for many years because the middle schools were so split up in where the kids went. There's less of that going on now, so the coaches are kind of able to go down to the middle school ranks and start training, and I know these coaches are doing that. But Tyler's the only 2 high school town in East Texas. Longview is a 1 high school district. Of course, there's also Spring Hill and Pine Creek within the city limits, but it's 2 Tyler high schools. So that was always an issue that they really tried to clean up, and I think they've done a pretty good job of that, and that'll help in the future. Blair Williams being helped off the field. So the Lobos lose 2 on that possession, on that bobble snap. And so now, with Harris still in the game, they've got the ball. Oh, it's Allen back. It's Harris. Harris under center at the 3. Second to go at the 3-yard line. Out formation. Hand off to Jackson, and he is at the goal line. Touchdown, Longview.
Touchdown, Jackson.
Second second of the night, and that makes it a 28-0 ball. Well, Dylan Jackson looking pretty good. I'm like you. Where'd he come from?
Well, you know, Longview, they also is known to breed good running backs too throughout the years.
And boy, they have here. Again, both these backup guys look pretty good. The extra point to come, which is sponsored by Brad Bergfeld and the Bergfeld Insurance Agency. The kick is up, and it is good. And so it's now 49-0. 6:36 to go in the third. We're back in 1 minute.
Local mortgage experts Tina Chumley and Robin Haba with Union Home Mortgage have guided thousands of home buyers down the path to home ownership. Just listen to what local customers are saying about Union Home Mortgage.
They took the intimidation out of it.
No matter what, regardless what you have going on, they're going to make sure that you're taken care of.
And they communicate.
We had a great experience. She was always available for us.
They worked with me on all the details and everything was great.
Union Home Mortgage, finding home financing options you need with the customer service you want.
You know Interstate for our dependable car batteries. We put that same quality into everything we do. A lot of things in our lives require batteries. And when they run low, you can count on Interstate All Battery Center to keep things going. Our custom battery rebuilds can put the charge back into your battery-powered devices. Ask our dependable customer service professionals about our family membership program and remote on-site battery services. Interstate All Battery Center in the Green Acre Shopping Center in Tyler and Loop 281 and Judson Road in Longview.
Sponsored by Thompson Tire Service. 49-0 Lobos after the 3-yard touchdown run by the Dylan Jackson. And let's just hope our player here from Tyler High is okay. Here is the training staff. Goes down to take care of him. Again, this is the final game for the Lions. They missed the playoffs for the second year in a row. Tyler High, John Tyler, for many, many years, one of the winningest programs in the history of the state of Texas. But a tough year for them. Both the Lobos and the Lions have state championship history. As John Tyler, they won 2 state titles, 73 and 94. Lobos had to wait 81 years before they finally got one 2 years ago, with John King's son Haynes leading him to the 2018 6A Division II championship at AT&T Stadium over Spring Westfield. Haynes now one of the quarterbacks, the young quarterback and heir apparent next year at the Texas A&M. Again, the Lion player who has been helped to his feet is up. And this year's the last game of the year. And the Lion player Cameron Ross has been assisted off the field. Won't have to worry about playing next week. The Lions will not be playing anywhere next week. And banged up pretty good that time as he is assisted off the field. So Cameron Ross, big help from the sidelines. And the Lions with Darius Cave in, it looks like, on the offensive line. They have really, really struggled trying to block this line. So that has been their Achilles heel.
The really also, I know Lobos, the line is good, especially caught. Probably hasn't been blocked. He hasn't been really blocked at all right now.
All right, so it's a first down at the 25-yard line. And now we're ready to play some football. Kenyonte Pinkard, in the quarterback, stays in since the first quarter. And the Sanchez went down. Hand off left side for about 2, maybe 3 hard yards for Josh Jones.
Hand off left side.
Second down and 7 coming up. Look at the leading rushers. the Lions leading rusher this year is Medlock at 4'08". Jones, 273 coming in, but he also scored four touchdowns. I'd love to get an opportunity to score another five tonight. That will be a second and seven coming up at the 28-yard line for the Lions. Offset back shotgun formation. Hand the ball off, and there's a very nice home in the top place. And it's Josh Jones, and it's a foot race. They won't catch it to the 15th, the 10-5, and that's a touchdown. And it's a 2-yard touchdown run. The Lions are on the board. Josh Jones burns the Lobos for 72-yard field. That is absolutely good. That was a very, again, the offensive line, what looked like a big track play, maybe, opened a huge hole for him. And we see the speed of Jones, who goes 72 for his fifth touchdown of the year. Extra point brought to you by Tim Jones, State Farm Insurance. And the extra point kick is up, and it is good. 5:40 to go in the third, and the Lions are on the board. Longview 49, Tiger High 7, back in 1 minute. 92.1.
Brian's Cheesecake, a little dessert shop in Mineola that's grown to make the best tasting cheesecakes you've ever had. But what's our secret? Well, we're happy to show you that 30 years of experience can't be replicated. All of our treats are homemade right here in Mineola, made from scratch and personally delivered to you. And now we are expanding our store closer to you in Tyler on Beckham. Come see why it only takes one bite to taste the difference. Brian's Cheesecakes, what can we make for you?
Visit Shannon's Beading Basket and Art Gallery, brand new store and location. We have thousands of beads, gemstones, semi-precious stones, freshwater pearls, findings, you name it, Shannon has it. Love designer jewelry? Design your own at a fraction of the cost. Shannon also has original art by local artists in her gallery. Come enjoy a creative experience with your friends and family you'll never forget. Shannon's Beading Basket and Art Gallery in front of the Triple Creek Shopping Center, 1412 Judson Road in Longview.
Now appears to be a playoff team next week somewhere. 7-9. score in the third quarter. Got a whole another quarter to go. Harris comes over to the sideline, goes to the far sideline, talks to the Lobo coaches. And they have a 39 to 37 is what they come up with. Split receivers, high formation, by the end of the quarterback. Roger Blitz, Harris on the rollout, he's going to be in trouble in the backfield. Elijah Johnson, who got the quarterback sack, back in the 43-yard line. That's just what the doctor ordered. You get a touchdown run, and then you stone the Lobos after a great kickoff return. And now they are forced to punt the ball away, so a good 5-minute stretch here for the title Lions.
Hopefully they can put some more points on the board. Please.
Again, like we said at halftime, if you can't win the game, let's go into the offseason on a high note. Here's the punt seven. Kick is away. It's a nice kick. A turnover. Fair caught it. No, it's caught at the three. And the return coming and nothing doing as the Lions try to return that punt and get it to the edge out to the 6-yard line. So that was well covered downfield. And the Lions will start at their own, near their own 6-yard line after Decora Gilliam's return. So again, it looks like they're going to mark at about the 6-yard line. So Kenyatta Pickard in that game. It's going to be a long, long way from Pedro. He
got that really nice and got that going in, James. I think we're about to win the game.
You've got to be aware of where you are on the field because they're going to save some yardage. So Pickard, another shotgun. On first down, hand the ball off and maybe 2 yards on that play on the left side. And again,
the handoff comes to Cameron Medlock.
Cameron Medlock from the six out to the eight.
Good job on the tackle.
2 yards on the tackle. Far side and short side again. The Lions moving left to right on your dial here in the third period. They lost to Sherman last week, knocked them out of playoff contention. And they're losing tonight. Two receivers fly to the near side. And Pickard bobbles the ball, and then kicks it upfield, I think. And I'm not sure you could do that. They're going to call that play. He tried to bat that ball out of the end zone, and you can't do that. Lance Mathis goes safety, and the Lions give up two more on a safety. That bad snap, bobble snap, back into the end zone. And Pickard has to eat the ball in effect for a 2-point safety, 51-7.
I went right between Cooper's hands. With the back snap, Bill, right between his hands. I don't know if he wasn't feeling attention or what, but he went right between Cooper's hands.
We don't see safeties very often, but when you let the ball go through your hands when you're that deep, and again, maybe it started with an ill-advised punt return by Corey Gilliam trying to make a play, tackled at the six, and 2 plays later, they have to eat it in the end zone. For safety, and the Lobos now leading 51-7, 2:37 left to go in the third quarter. And again, I think Coach King has been very generous tonight to try to hold his score down. He has been, I think, more than generous.
Absolutely. Coach King is rewarding his second and third team players. They get out just like the first teamers and brush their foot and practice. And the only thing the first team is just to reward more than the other guys. That's good.
But no scoring in the second quarter. Here in the third quarter so far, 2 touchdown runs by Jackson, a safety, and a touchdown run by Lion tailback Jock Jones. And so the Lions like to pair the free kick from the 20-yard line. So the Lobos could get good field position out of this. And this ball will be fielded with the 30-yard line. Our field here found the Lobos again. There's another business coming by the Cooper Painter. He nearly ran one back on the open kickoff of the 30. Takes this one to the tire at 36-yard line on that return. And they all get up talking to each other. Lobos will start first and 10 at the time of 36. They return the kickoff 17 and then return the free kick on the arms after the safety from the 36-yard line. So the Lobos are not only good, but the Lions are not doing that for what themselves, but the bad special. And the last 2 times they have returned the free kicks. So now we get the Lobo Lobos at the 36-yard line. The backs are standing left to right, left to right of Isaiah, the quarterback. And he's going to keep it. The Lions are all over, and they wrestle him down and drop it in the backfield. Keeper that time by Harris, a great job, comes right up the middle, and Ashton Williams caught off a block and drops the Lobo quarterback for a one-yard line. Minute 35 to go in the third, Ashton Williams. Well, he's going to get a nice job that time. This is his senior year. And playing his final game here, Chris, with Timmy Miller, Francis Miller Stadium. And a couple of really nice plays there for the second.
He's a leader on that defensive line.
Second down to 11, 36. Second down, Terry Howard shotgun. Takes a snap, hand the ball to Jackson. Jackson's been deadly. 30, 25, 20, and he may go again. It's a five, and he's in. Did he make it into the end zone? He may have been bounced out at the one-yard line, and he was.
Jackson.
Dale Jackson is having himself a night. Finally bounced out of bounds. They're going to stay at the two-yard line. First and goal.
I don't know what David Jackson is going to say.
The Lobos does have running backs by committee, Bill. We've seen three good ones. Well, actually, four.
Well, and they're going to have to deal with him next year. So,
yes, sir, he does.
I know Merrill's good, but this kid is probably the Lobo tailback next year. First and goal at the two-yard line. They go double tight end. And the keeper by Harris, and he dives for the end zone, and he crossed the ground. Lost the ball, but he already hit the ground. Touchdown, Lobo. Isaiah Harris. So Isaiah Harris, the second Lobo quarterback tonight, punches it in. And the Major's Pharmacy extra point coming up to make it a 58-7 ball game, and the kick is good.
8 years ago, my daughter called to say she was expecting our first grandchild.
But I never actually heard her say that. And the first time my granddaughter called me Papa, I didn't hear that one either. Can you imagine? Oh, I know I lost some of my hearing, but I was embarrassed, too stubborn to admit that. For Father's Day a few years ago, Gina and Ryan bought me a Nano hearing aid. And my precious Ryan, I love hearing her call me Papa. I love hearing everything again.
What if you not hurt by not wearing a hearing aid? You're going to have many more special moments in your life. Don't miss hearing a single one of them. Call Nano. Order your full pair of hearing aids for only $297.
1-800-244-6488.
Make today the day you finally start hearing better again with Nano hearing aids.
1-800-244-6488. 1-800-244-6488.
Picked up by the Lions at the 31-yard line. Upfield with the 37. This is Medlock. He'll be dropped there by the Lobos. At the 37-yard line. 25 seconds left to go in the third quarter. And every quarter tonight, except the second, is very slow moving to the first of the Dartmouth Troy. And at this point, we know that the Lobos own this one. It's 58-7. Cost of safety on that one. Tyler Hyde takes over, and they would love to score another touchdown, but I think we get the point here tonight that the Lobos better team than this one. Four wide receivers, and the ball off, nothing doing. McFall, I think, was the ball carrier that time. I don't know if you have the number. And he was buried.